For this little interruption, so I'll introduce you to the project I've been working on for almost a year now. To be really honest, I at first didn't think that I would release it as a full project, but when I started it. I started this project from the backtrack distribution, so it's a fork. I don't know if you guys know the backtrack distribution, but I started to play with the version 4 of backtrack. And I said to myself, it's a great distribution, but it missed a few things, and I really thought that I could do better. So I kept modifying it day after day, and the Shadow Circle project came. So. Ah, okay. No. It missed some slide. Yeah. So, like I said, Shadow Circle is a GNU Linux live distribution, so you can use it live, like backtrack. So, mainly designed for security and auditing purposes. And it embeds a full set of tools like backtrack. So you've got penetration frameworks and information gathering tools like XProbe or Nmap for port scanning or. I indicated you that the project was forking from backtrack, since the beginning of this year, I decided to split to start with a new base and make the project evolve with the Ubuntu system. And take the yet in development Lucid Lynx branch about LTS long term support. For now the Ubuntu branch isn't available on the Shadow Circle repositories because it's still under development, but it will be available something like mid 2010. So. So the main features that are different from the backtrack distribution. First, it features an XFCE desktop. For a few reasons, we thought that it was the best desktop to introduce in this kind of systems. Because it's light and because it has a small memory footprint and it's quite performant and also we choose to remove the Saint vulnerability scanner that is in the backtrack distribution and go with OpenVAS, which is a Nessus fork and which is very good with plenty of NASL plugins for vulnerability checks. It's a very active project too, so we get many updates from the community, and it's great. And we also feature custom tools that are mostly developed in PyGTK, so it's mostly GUI tools. I do not have screenshots here, but if you want to see what these tools are, I invite you to go to the www.shadowcircle.com.org page. So the image, it's released as an ISO image, which is only 700 megabytes. So many people may think, after all, why starting another penetration testing dedicated distribution? So to me, it's the main reason why another concurrent may be introduced in this kind of operating system. So first, distribution like Backtrack don't really care about integrating proprietary software. So the politics of Shadow Circle is clearly to remove all this proprietary software and eventually recode them if needed. I'll talk about a side project of Shadow Circle later, but it's a main point. And another important fact in the concurrent distribution is that they assume that you already know their tools, so you don't really have a local knowledge base, or it's incomplete, and we really want to fix that and make something really. Well, when the user wants to use a tool, he must find the information almost instantly and get started with the tool and they also sometimes like lack of rigor and finishing. You know, sometimes some packets are not even integrated in the package in the package manager. They are just placed in the file system tree, just like that. And it can be a little messy sometimes. And Averatic relay cycle, because it's done when it's done, and they don't have really fixed. Right now Shadow Circle is in the same case, but we really hope to fix things and to make a regular release cycle. So, like I said, the philosophy of the project is the respect of the elementary free and open source software principle. So remove all the proprietary software. Learn while using. Like I said, I really want to integrate real help for users inside the distribution and also outside with an online knowledge base, but a really consequent online knowledge base. And get strong community interaction. That's the main point about any open source and community driven projects. And also the integration of the tool and their behavior together. We are trying to work on tools that would aggregate other tools, but it's kind of complicated to explain, again, if you need more information, I invite you to go to the website. So here is a little list of custom tools we've been coding for to integrate in the Shadow Circle distribution. So the most important are Shadow install, which is a PyGTK installer. It allows to install the distribution on hard drive if you don't want to run it anymore in live. And you've got also Shadow updates, which takes all the main tools like Metasploit or OpenVAS or other security frameworks and perform a wall update because if you have ever made penetration testings, you know that your vulnerability database and vulnerability checks must be really up to date. So that's why we made this tool. And well, this is a little roadmap. So removal of all the proprietary software. There are still a few software in the Shadow SQL Bass distribution that are proprietary, like Maltego. It's a data miner. It's a great data miner, but we want to change it and develop our side project, which will be called Zero Farm, and it will be coded in C, C++, and GTK UI. So writing improvement of the existing tools to make them more accurate and more reliable. And also, most important, writing of the knowledge tool. Like I said, it's a really big point. I really want my users to be able to use the tool really quickly and really simply, and that's very important. So, creation of own package repository later. Well, for now we're using the Ubuntu repositories like Backtrace does. But we will create later. We also want to create. It's not written on the slides, but we also want to create a tool that would aggregate all the reports produced by Nmap or OpenVAS and other auditing tools, and aggregate them and produce something really clear, it would be great. So it's another project. So misinformation. So for this operating system, we are two maintainers. We would need voluntary people to help if they want. The release cycle we expect will be two major releases per year. That's it. So still another need you call. And also on the side project Zero Farm. So as I explained earlier, it would be a Maltego replacement. So we need any skill basically is appreciated too, but mainly C++ developer, which have for some skills in search APIs. So. And here are the web references, so you can go and check for yourself what the project is. Do you guys have any question or?